Hello everyone. In this video, we will see how to use accuracy and validation graphs to identify high bias and high variance. First of all, let's see what is meant by bias. Bias is algorithm's error on training data set. It indicates how much error is there in your model while training a data. Let's see how to identify bias in a model from graph. Here are three different graphs available with model, each indicating accuracy of that model. Blue line indicate the training accuracy and orange line indicates validation accuracy. So in the first graph, as we can see, training accuracy is less than 6%. So we can say that this model is not appropriately trained on the training data. Since bias is associated with only training data, we can conclude that it is highly biased because on the training data itself, we are getting accuracy less than 60%. Now coming to the high variance part, we'll check what is meant by variance. Variance indicates how much worse the algorithm works on dev or testing set. Now in the third graph, we can see that training accuracy is very high. It is close to 10, that is 100%. But when we will check our validation accuracy is very less compared to the training accuracy, and it is close to 40%. So there is huge difference. Our model is trained well on the training data set, but when it comes to the unseen data, its accuracy drops drastically. So here we can say that our model is trained appropriately and it has learned very complex function, but it is not appropriate to work with the unseen data. This indicates high variance. Now let's check out some of the example. If the training error set is 10 and development set error is 90, then error introduced in a dev set is very high compared to the 10% in training. So it is high variance. High variance is also called as overfitting. It is learning everything from the given samples, but on the unseen data, it is not able to predict the correct output. Second example, we have 80% error in train set and 70% error in dev set. Then it is called as high bias. Why? Because we have to first concentrate on training error. Training error itself is very high, then our model is highly biased model. It is also called as underfitting. Bias is also called as underfitting. Coming to the third example, our training error is comparatively less than the dev set error. Dev set error is 90%. So we can say that our model is highly biased and highly variance model. Why? Because training error is considerably high. Along with that, variance, that is dev error, is also very high. So it is called as highly biased, highly variance model. It is also called as underfitting. Then what is good fitting? Both these errors, like training error and testing error, is very small. Okay, so coming to the accuracy graph, we can say that training error and testing error are less. So in the middle graph, we can see that accuracy for training and testing is close to 100%. Means we are achieved the same accuracy for training as well as testing, that is on the seen data and on the unseen data. So this is good fit. Model should achieve good fit, not the high bias and the high variance. So in order to avoid high bias, we can use different methods. Like we can increase the model size. If suppose we have used two hidden layers, then try to include more hidden layers, which will reduce the high bias. Means it will reduce the training error. Means it will increase the training accuracy. Sometimes it might be possible that input features are creating certain problems in training. So we can identify such input features and we can remove these features. We can also use dropouts. Dropout will randomly remove the nodes from the layers, which will avoid concentration of learning on one particular node. Regularization is another way with which we can reduce the high bias. For that, we can use L1 or L2 regularization. We can reduce the high bias also by changing the model architecture. So whatever the model architecture we have created, that might not be suitable for the input data. So we have to modify the model in order to reduce the training error. Coming to the high variance, we can reduce the high variance with the help of different methods. First and most important, add more training data. Another way is early stopping. Early stopping means we have to identify the point after which validation error grows. So whichever the point we have identified, just we have to stop the training there itself, so that we will reduce the high variance. We can also use L1 and L2 regularization, which will avoid learning high valued weights, which will help us to reduce high variance. And last one, we can modify the model architecture, which might not be suitable for our input data set. So we are going to check out how to deal with early stopping, regularization, how to add more layers, and how to modify the architectures in the upcoming videos. Thank you for watching the video.